Darth Bane advised, "One day the Republic will fall and the Jedi will be wiped out. But that will not happen until we are ready to seize that power for ourselves." "When?" Sidious said. "How will we know when the time is right?" "We are close to knowing. For 1,000 years, the Sith have allowed themselves to be reduced to the stuff of folklore. Since it serves our purposes, we've done nothing to counter the belief that we are perversions of the Jedi. Evil magus, embodiments of hatred, rage, and bloodlust. Capable even of leaving the residue of our malefactions and dastardly deeds in places of power."
"Why have we not yet visited those places, Master? Instead of worlds like Boyant and Hypore?"
Darth Plagueis gazed at him. "You are impatient. You see no value in learning about weapons or explosives, force suggestion, or the healing arts. You hunger for the power of the sort you imagine is to be found on Korriban, Dromund Kaas, Zigula. Then let me tell you what you'll encounter in those reliquaries. Jedi, treasure hunters, and legends. Of course, there are tombs in the Valley of the Dark Lords, but they have been plundered and now draw only tourists. On Duxon, Yavin 4, Zyost, the same is true. If it's history that has caught your fancy, I can show you 100 worlds on which esoteric Sith symbols have been woven covertly into architecture and culture, and I can bore you for years with tales of the exploits of Freedon Nadd, Belial Darzu, Darth Zanna, who is alleged to have infiltrated the Jedi Temple, and of starships imbued with Sith consciousness. Is that your wish, Sidious? To become an academic?"
"I wish only to learn, Master."
"And so you will, but not from spurious sources. We are not some cult like the Tetsu sorcerers of Tund. Descended from Darth Bane, we are the select few who refuse to be carried by the Force and who carry it instead. 30 in a millennium, rather than the tens of thousands fit to be Jedi. Any Sith can feign compassion and self-righteousness and master the Jedi arts. But only 1 in 1,000 Jedi could ever become a Sith. For the dark side is only for those who value self-determinism over all else that existence offers. Only once in these past 1,000 years has a Sith Lord strayed into the light. And one day I will tell you that tale. But for now, take to heart the fact that Bane's Rule of Two was at the start our saving grace, putting an end to the internecine strife that allowed the Jedi Order to gain the upper hand. Part of our ongoing task will be to hunt down and eliminate any Sith pretenders who pose a threat to our ultimate goals." Sidious remained silent for a long moment.
"Am I to be equally distrustful of the lessons contained in Sith holocrons?"
"Not distrustful," Plagueis said gravely. "But holocrons contain knowledge specific and idiosyncratic to each Sith who constructed them. Real knowledge is passed by master to apprentice in sessions such as this, where nothing is codified or recorded, diluted, and thus it cannot be forgotten. There will come a time when you may wish to consult the holocrons of past masters. But until then, you would do better not to be influenced by them. You must discover the dark side in your own way, and perfect your power in your own fashion. All I can do in the meantime is to help keep you from losing your way while we hide in plain sight from the prying eyes of our enemies."
"What celestial body is more luminous than a singularity," Sidious recited. "Hiding in plain sight, but more powerful than all."
Plagueis grinned. "You are quoting Darth Guile."
"He goes on to compare the Sith to a rogue or malignant cell, too small to be discovered by scans or other techniques, but capable of spreading silently and lethally through a system. Initially, the victim simply doesn't feel right. then falls ill, and ultimately succumbs. Plagueis locked eyes with him.
Consider the mindset of an anarchist who plans to sacrifice himself for a cause. For the weeks, months, possibly years, leading up to the day he straps a thermal detonator to his chest and executes his task, he has lived in and been strengthened by the secret he carries, knowing the toll his act will take. So it has been for the Sith, residing in a secret, sacred place of knowledge for 1,000 years, and knowing the toll our acts will take. This is power, Sidious. Where the Jedi, by contrast, are like beings who, as they move among the healthy, keep secret the fact that they are dying of a terminal illness. But true power needn't bear claws or fangs, or announce itself with snarls and throaty barks, Sidious. It can subdue with manacles of shimmer silk, purposeful charisma, and political astuteness.